Hi everyone, welcome to Mash Math. Today we are going to study chapter 8, Introduction to Trigonometry, exercise 8.4, question 2. Write all the other trigonometric ratios of angle A in terms of sec A. So all the other trigonometric ratios, what are the trigonometric ratios? That is prince beating princess, horribly beating. So P for perpendicular, H for hypotenuse, B for base, and this can be written. These are the trigonometric ratios, that is sine, cos, tan, cos sec, sec, cot. So all these ratios we have to trigonometric ratio, no, all the other trigonometric ratios of angle A means theta in terms of sec A. So that means sine, cos, tan, cosec and cot, we have to express them in terms of sec. Okay, so how we did question 1, same way we can do it. So two ways you can do it. One is complete the triangle and just write the values. Another is using the trigonometric identities that I have explained to you. Trigonometric identities you have to learn by heart. If you know this by heart, the more you practice, then only you will be able to do this using the trigonometric identities. Otherwise you can complete the triangle and use it. So both the way I'll just show you. First of all, let's complete the triangle method that I will show you. Okay, so for sec A, so sec A is what actually sec is what actually hypotenuse upon base. Hypotenuse upon base is sec. So that means we have hypotenuse, we have base. So we have to find out perpendicular. So for that, let us draw a right angle triangle. So this is our right angle triangle. Since it is said angle A, so we keep angle A as the acute angle, that is theta, that is A. Okay, A is our theta angle. So A, then B and C. Okay, so now opposite to theta becomes perpendicular, opposite to 90 degree becomes hypotenuse, and this becomes base. Okay, so now we know that hypotenuse upon base is sec. So here in denominator nothing is there, so we consider that there is 1. So that means hypotenuse is sec A, base is 1. So let's write down, hypotenuse is actually what? Sec A, and base is what? 1. Okay, so we have to find out perpendicular. So we use Pythagoras theorem. So according to Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse is what here actually? That is AC, right? So AC square equal to base is what? Base is BA. So BA square. Perpendicular what? BC. BC square. So now hypotenuse value AC is sec A. Sec A square is there, sec square A. BA is what? 1 square. BC is perpendicular, we don't know. So we keep it as it is. Okay, so now sec square A, this 1 square will become 1 only, 1 into 1. 1 into 1 will give us 1 only, right? So 1 plus BC square. So let's bring this 1 this side because we want to find out BC square. So sec square A, 1 comes this side becomes minus. Now BC square we have. So now square you bring it this side. So then this goes becomes under root. Sec square A minus 1 equal to BC. So our BC value we found out, perpendicular value is what actually? Root sec square A minus 1. So this is our perpendicular. So we found out perpendicular, we know base, we know hypotenuse value. So all three values we know. Now just put all the other trigonometric ratio, sine, cos, tan, cosec and cot value, let us write down. So sec A will be, because it is given there, angle A. So sec A is what? Sec, first we have to write sine, cos and tan. So first will come sine. Okay, so sine A. So sine is what actually? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So our perpendicular value is what? Perpendicular is root sec square A minus 1. And hypotenuse is sec A. See, sine A we have expressed in the terms of sec. You see, all the other trigonometric ratios of angle A in terms of sec A. So we have turned sine into a sec expression. So next we can write for cos A. Cos is what? Cos is base upon hypotenuse. So base upon hypotenuse. Base is what? Base is 1. Hypotenuse is sec A. That's it. Then comes tan A. So tan is what actually? Tan is perpendicular upon base. So perpendicular is what here? Perpendicular is root sec square A minus 1. Base is 1. So whether you write in denominator 1 or you don't write, it's the same because it has no value. So if you want to write, you can write. Since there is no value, our answer will be sec square A minus 1. Okay, so tan is over. Now cosec A. So cosec is what actually? Hypotenuse upon perpendicular. Hypotenuse here sec A, and perpendicular is the root sec square A minus 1. So now next, what is remain? Sec we should not write because all other ratios we are writing in the terms of sec. So now let's write for cot. So cot. Cot is what? Cot is base upon perpendicular. So base is what here? 1. Perpendicular is what? The root square sec square A minus 1. See? So all the other trigonometric ratios we have expressed in terms of sec. Everything is expressed. Okay. So this is one easy method for you to write this question. Or else you have to write a, or you have to express it in terms of identity. That is, you have to write like this. Sine A. So sine A can be written according to the identity, you see. If you have this, you have to learn. Identity you have to learn. Okay. Sine square plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So if you are, you have to turn this. Okay. Sine, we have to now, all these terms, you have to bring it to sec. So to get sec, what we need? To get sec, you have to turn into cos, you see. When sine you convert into cos, then cos can be converted into sec. So that's how you will get it. So here sine A can be written under root. I have told you like this, right? Question A. This x square can be, if square get cancelled, means a square root also will go. So we get x. So same x can be written under square root. Okay. So same way sine A can be written as sine square A under root. Okay, so when it is in under root, now sine square can be written how? So sine square theta can be written 1 minus cos square theta. So sine square theta we can write 1 minus cos square theta. Theta is here A. So now this 1 is here. Cos can be written 1 upon sec. You see, cos can be written as 1 upon sec because cos is inverse of sec. Cos is what actually inverse of sec. So, cos can be written 1 upon sec. So, 1 upon sec. Since square is the sec square A. Now, if we take the LCM, we will get sec square A minus 1 upon sec square A. Now, this upper part we can't do anything. So, we can write it as it is. Sec square A minus 1. But then down square if you remove root will go for this. So, then we can write this sec A. So, this is our answer for the first term, that is sine, we have converted into sec. So, if you see here, you see same answer. Here also same. So, this is using the identity and solving this way. This, if you can't remember the identity, you can solve this way and then get the correct answers. Okay. So, one more I will do. The other ones you can do it. So, now for cos. So, cos, how can we write? Cos, we know that is inverse of sec. It is. So, directly we are getting it. So cos, you see. Cos is 1 upon sec only. So, directly we can write 1 upon sec A. So, now next for tan. Tan A. So, now tan A, how can we, same way we can put it in the under root square. So, tan square A we can put it. So, tan square A gives us what? Tan square theta. See. Tan square theta is what equal to sec square theta minus 1. So, we can write sec square A minus 1. So, converted into sec. So, we stop it here. So, now next for cosec. Cosec A. Now, cosec can be written with sin because in cosec is what actually? Cosec is 1 upon sine. So, we can write this cosec 1 upon sine A. Why we are writing sine? So that sine will turn into cos and then cos can give us the sec. How we did here, you see sine turns into cos and cos we can turn into sec. So that's why we are doing this way. So then this can be again as we did here can do. This can be written in root sine square A and then 1 upon. See, sin square A gives us what? Gives us 1 minus cos square A. And then we can, this can be written as this way. 1 root 1 minus cos square A. Cos square A gives us 1 upon sec square A. This way. And then we can take the LCM here. So, if you take the LCM, we will get the same thing here. Sec square A minus 1 upon sec square A. Okay. Again, we can further solve up to here. We will get sec square A minus 1 upon sec A we will get. So, now this sec A, we can bring it up. So, then we will get sec A upon the root sec square A minus 1. The same answer only we are getting, you see, for sec. Sec A upon under root sec square A minus 1. So, same thing only we are getting. So, now, last what is left is cot. Cot A. Now, cot also, how we can turn? Cot is actually what? Cot is? Cot is inverse of tan. So, once you get a tan, then we have done for tan already. So, same way you can do it. So, cot can be written 1 upon tan A. So, then same way tan can be written. We can put it in square tan square A, which will give us 1 upon tan square A can be written as sec square A minus 1. So, we have already converted that into more than this we can't convert. So, this is our answer. I hope it is clear to you, because if you have to use the identity, you should be very sure of the identity, then only you can solve this sum. So you, for that you have to learn the identity. If at all you cannot remember the identity, you can try this method where easily we get it. That's it. Thank you and God bless.